Barcelona and Real Sociedad. Barcelona win 2-1. There's highs and there's lows overall. And you can't just be Griezmann focused in your answer.
Really good first half, I thought, from Barcelona in a lot of respect. I like Pedri. I like Jordi Alba, of course, who scored and assisted.
With his wrong foot.
With his wrong foot as well. Great goal. Second half, I thought it was more difficult. And again, it's not. I don't want to be always all negative on Koeman.
What was the formation? Did you not like his 4-1-5 formation?
So,
is 4-1 chaos for me? If you look Frankie de Jong playing center forward?
If you look at the average positions, he almost looked like a 4-4-2 because Pedri and Messi are quite central together. Then you've got Braithwaite on the left.
Yeah.
And Griezmann a bit on the right.
Now Griezmann coming into the middle. And then Frankie de Jong effectively playing up front. I mean, this is the crazy thing.
It's chaos, but chaos worked in that first half. And then as soon as he makes his silly, stupid substitutions, which he always does, then he goes pear-shaped and they almost like drop 2 points because Real Sociedad could have scored at the end.
Yeah, I almost felt... And by the way, just for context, this was a Real Sociedad team playing without arguably their best player, Mikel Oyarzabal, and definitely their most experienced, most talented player, at least as a passer, in David Silva. Yeah. And this was a Real Sociedad which, of course, started the season like a house on fire and then started, you know, losing points. So you figure, all right, they're losing confidence. But they were in it. They were in it until the very, very end.
Big time. Big time.
But that says more about Barca and the fact that there's still a lot of insecurity there. There's tactical imbalance. There's Koeman's stupid substitution.
Yeah, there is. Yeah, and there's still a lot of issues. And Messi has to be a worry in a sense because although I thought he was very vocal and he was always encouraging and you could see he was very committed, very involved, I don't think there's just enough. I don't know if it's because fitness-wise he's not 100% and he's not ready to have the intensity that he usually plays with. I don't know if it's his age. I don't know if he's really unhappy there.
He looked more engaged in this game, but he was not. I mean,
in terms of performances,
he did not produce. No,
this is not good.
No. He appears and then he disappears. Yeah. There's clearly, I think, in parallel to the 4-1 chaos formation, there's clearly another issue there. I want to give a shout out to Pedri because I don't know if this made the highlight reels, but this game would have ended in a draw if not for the fact that this kid, I don't know where the hell he was coming from because he was playing at the other end of the pitch, goes and legs at the length of the pitch, and he makes an incredible sort of decisive tackle on Alexander Isak, who's through on goal, and then he goes and he just face plants into the post. I mean, that guy's got big stones. Yes. He's 18 years old, and I'll tell you what. I say this in a positive way. He doesn't look like a Barcelona player. Doesn't look like a La Masia product in the
which
sense.
Which he isn't. So maybe he's just normal.
But how much time did he spend there? He was there a year, right?
Yeah.
But he doesn't look like the kind of he isn't. But he has that presence, that intensity, which I'm not saying people like Xavi Iniesta didn't have it, but they certainly at 18, even if they were really, really good, they were a certain kind of player.
Yeah.
This guy plays like a veteran. He plays like he's the boss on the pitch, which is really unusual when you're that young.
It's really impressive. It's really impressive.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.